Cricut has come out with this new feature, and we're going to check it out today. My name is Corinne Blackstone, and welcome to my channel. If you're new here, be sure to subscribe, that way you don't miss out on any fun, crafty content we have coming. Now, today's video, we're going to go over the new Create Sticker feature that is an access exclusive feature with Cricut, meaning you will need to have their Design Space Access subscription to use this feature. But just know, I do have some videos down below how to do exactly what this feature does without actually having Design Space access. So let's go ahead and get started. We have a new exciting update in Cricut. And when I say exciting, I maybe mean exciting. So what you want to do to access this new feature is you're going to need to be in the beta version of Design Space. To access that, go to your profile up here at the top and click the down arrow. Go to settings, and this first menu that comes up under general, you want to go to application experience and change it over to beta. Now make sure that you've saved your project before you do this if you're working on something currently, because you will lose your access, like you'll lose the project if you don't save it. So then go ahead and click done, and it will reload your Cricut Design Space. Now obviously behind you, you see the recording software, but I want to show you this because it's going to install an update, which might take a moment, but let it do that update. And once that's done, you'll have your Design Space beta ready to work. We're going to use something pretty simple just to start because it is new. It was running a little bit slow when I tried to do it with more complicated SVGs. So for now, we're just going to use some PNGs, and I thought these were just so darn cute. So all I have to do is click download. I'm going to download these pretty quickly. They're really simple to work with. So I'm going to download them. I'm going to put them into my Cricut folder. And then I have a folder that is for videos only that I use. And I'm just going to click save. Now I will need to extract my folder to use these. So I'm just going to open it up and click extract. Super easy to do this and really, really simple. Once it's extracted, we'll be able to preview all of the images to choose the one that we want to use. You'll see here it's bringing up all of our different images, so we can choose a couple that we want to use, but we'll just start with one off the bat, and this little penguin one is adorable, so let's do that one. Let's head over to Cricut Design Space beta and give this a shot. Over in Design Space, we'll of course need to upload our design, so click upload, and then I want to click upload image, and I can browse for it or I can just drag and drop. I'm a big fan of drag and drop, so I'm just going to drag it and drop it over into my design. Now it is going to tell me it's large because it's a high quality image. That's fine. Go ahead and choose complex, click continue, and then all you have to do on this screen is click apply and continue once it loads, because it already has the background removed. Now again, because this image is pretty large, it might take a second to load, but we'll size it down in Design Space so it'll move a lot quicker. Make sure that you select your print then cut image and choose upload. I'm going to select that image and add it to my canvas. Now again, this might take a second for it to load in because it is going to be quite large, and we'll size it down right away so that we can work with it. See how big it is? It's 18 inches wide. Let's just size it down to 4 inches wide, and that gives us a much smaller design to work with. Now the next thing I am going to do to make it easier for us to see what our stickers are doing is I'm going to change the color of our canvas by selecting blank canvas. And I just want to change it to gray. That way we can see the outline a little bit better. I'm also going to duplicate our cupcake penguin guy because I'm going to use him for something else. Like, we're going to try the two different versions of our stickers. So let's just start with this one. And what you're going to see is up here at the top, we have Create Sticker. Now this is for Design Space Access members only, but don't worry, if you don't have Design Space Access, I have tons of videos that show you how to do these exact same things without using Design Space Access. But since this is a new tool, let's give it a shot. We have two options. We have die cut, and that basically means it's going to cut all the way through the sticker paper and the backing to create a sticker that will sit by itself individually. A kiss cut leaves all the stickers on the same sheet. And again, I've taught you guys how to do both of those types of things, and I'll link a bunch of videos down below. So let's start with the top one of the die cut. We're going to select that. Now this gives us some options. We have a border, which we can choose, and then we also have this cut interior shapes. What that does is it'll fill in any items like this cup handle right here so that it doesn't cut those out. You can have it cut them out if you want to, but I think for this one, we won't. Now what I want to do is choose a border. There's thin, standard, wide, and custom. So let's look at thin and see what that looks like. You can see now we have this really little border, and you can see that all these little pieces around the outside are gonna cut individually. We definitely don't want it to do that, so let's try doing a standard border and see if that connects everything a little bit better. I don't know what Design Space just thought it was doing, but it all of a sudden kind of went a little crazy. So that's one of the things with beta that you have to be prepared for, is that sometimes it's going to do crazy things like that. So just know that it is still in beta testing, which means it may not work perfectly every single time. So we're going to skip standard and just try wide, because I think the wide is the only one that's really going to work with the shapes that we have anyways. So all we have to do from here is click apply. Now you can change the color of your outside border if you want to. It's really up to you. I'm just going to leave it white and I'm going to click apply. Now from here, let's go ahead and grab this one. And for this one, let's do the Create Sticker Kiss Cut and see what happens. So with this one, we also have those options of cutting interior shapes and the border. But now we have this die cut edge option. So first, let's choose our border, and that way while that's loading, we can kind of talk about die cut edge. The die cut edge is basically what we know as crafters is the easy peel sticker. So this is going to create that easy peel border for you by itself. I personally prefer to do it myself just because your cut settings are going to be a little bit weird, but we're going to test this out with some of the sticker paper that I have here on hand and see how it works and see if it does what we think it should do. So what I'm going to do is select this die cut edge option. It's going to load and you're going to see that we'll have an additional border around it where it's going to cut. Now you're not going to see it for some reason right now until you hit apply. It's kind of weird, but if you click apply and give it a second, usually it will show up. I've noticed that I've been playing with this a little bit and it's a little funny sometimes. And sometimes I just have to click off of it and there's our border. So you see on this one how our border has this additional white around it. It's actually going to cut out all the way through on the very outside, and then on this inside portion, it's just going to cut through just enough to give us that one layer that will come off. Now, I do recommend always saving your project, so I'm just going to save this as Penguin Cup sticker, and then we are going to go ahead and get ready to print this, and I think we might actually need to size them down a little bit so that they'll fit on the same page, just to save us some space and to see if it'll actually allow us to do that. Now, see what I mean about it doing little crazy things? You can see that I moved it and it just wanted to move on its own. But I am going to size these down quite a bit just so that they'll fit onto our printable page a little bit better. Then I'm going to save it again and I'll take you over and show you how to print these. So just so I'm not wasting a ton of materials, I did duplicate this, and let me tell you what an adventure that certainly was. I think it's just because it's in beta, but boy was it glitchy. Every once in a while, like, one would show up, one wouldn't. Then I tried to resize and some of them would disappear. It was really awful. So instead of duplicating, I'm just doing two project copies, which just might be easier if you're having troubles with it as well. Now what we're going to do is click continue, and from here we are going to click send to printer. This is not immediately going to send it to your printer, it's just going to bring up your print setup box. Now I'm going to be using an inkjet printer, and for this, just to make it easier to see where the easy peel is, I'm going to use some holographic paper from Haze. I'm going to leave the bleed on. It really doesn't totally matter with white outline. And then I'm going to use my system dialog. Then I'm going to click print. And again, this isn't going to send it to your printer, but this is going to bring up our printer preferences so that we can make sure that this prints out really nicely. Now, just because we're testing it, you don't necessarily have to use like a high quality print. But because I'm going to show you guys how to do this, I thought I would show you every step. So you want to make sure that the printer you're using is selected. So again, I'm using my EcoTank 2720, and I'm going to be using my preferences, which is that little button right there. The first thing I want to do is I always change my paper type. Now for my holographic, I do find that the premium photo paper semi-gloss works really, really well for that, but you're going to want to test out your printer and see what works for the type of material you're using, because it might be different. I changed my quality from standard to high. And then I go into my more options button and I turn off my high speed print. Yours might say bi-directional printing, it's the same thing. Then click OK and click print to send it to your printer. Then I'm going to show you how to select your cut setting.
So now that we have printed out and we're ready to cut, you'll notice that it's only giving us compatible materials. That's because we did this using the Create Sticker option, and they're only doing it for Cricut materials. You can't choose any of your bookmarked or the popular items. You can only choose from compatible items. Now, if we click Browse All Materials, you'll see that it lists a ton of different options. Now, I have not tried cutting this holographic paper on any of the new cut settings from Cricut. So I think what I'm gonna do is just try to find one that looks like it's probably closer to what I'm printing on already. So we've got printable iron-on, dark and light, definitely not those ones. And it's not a paper. So what I wanna do is I wanna kinda look here, and we've got specialty, transparent, gray lining paper, gray liner, green liner paper, transparent, transparent holographic, white, and white holographic. Now what I can do is I can actually view my material settings and find those different settings down here. This is kind of not set up the way that I would like it to be, but that's okay. But what you can do is you can scroll through here and find those different materials, and you'll be able to look at what their pressure is set to, if they're set to cut more than once, things like that. So that's just something that you can do and take a look at to see if any of these are going to match up with what you want it to print. But you can see every single material in here. Now to exit this, you have to go all the way to the bottom or to the top to do so. But I'm down here looking at the printables. So what I think that the one I'm probably going to go with, I'm kind of debating between the white holographic or the transparent holographic. But I think let's go with the transparent holographic and just see what happens. I don't love the setup of this, so you know, that is what it is, what it is. So let's see if we can find that over here. I don't know if they had that one as, let's just click Browse All Materials. That was way easier to see. So I want to use the transparent holographic setting. I'm going to click Done. Now this cuts with just your regular old fine point blade. Now this does say to, before cutting, apply laminate sheet over printed sticker sheet. We're not gonna do that with this holographic paper. Again, this is kind of one of those things, because we're working with something that Cricut made. They made it specifically for their product. So I don't know that this will work great, but I'm gonna link those videos down below for you that explains how to do this in a better way, in my opinion, because you can use your own materials. We're ready to load our mat with our stickers. So the top ones up here are the ones that have that easy peel edge, and then the ones down here are the other ones, which I believe were called the kiss cuts. So I'm gonna go ahead and load this. You wanna load the paper the same direction that it is in your design space. And then we're gonna load this in and let this cut out. I don't have a lot of confidence since we had to use a Cricut cut setting for this, and not a cut setting that I know works with this product. So now that it's done cutting, before I unload this, I am gonna pull the backing off. And just as I thought, even what was supposed to be a kiss cut, meaning that it would be on the backing still and we would peel the big part of the backing off, it cut all the way through. So I have a feeling it did the same for our die cut. Like I said, this is not probably something I would recommend unless you're using a Cricut product, which again, we know we don't recommend. But let's take a look. I'm gonna go ahead and peel these off. And it did cut through the little outline mostly. It didn't cut all the way through, but it definitely cut enough through that, like, it's definitely, like, I could peel this off. But in general, I mean, the sticker itself did cut correctly as far as, you know, having the outline, as they called it, even though it's just an offset. And it did cut the easy peel section, which I can peel off. That way you guys can see kind of what it's supposed to look like if it hadn't like cut all the way through. Now I will say sometimes I have a hard time getting this holographic to come off the backing. Okay, here we go. I got it to start. Now, like I said, this probably is gonna lift a little bit, but this is just in general, if it cut correctly, what it should look like.
So you see here we have a white edge to the sticker, and that would just make it easier to peel off when you go to take the sticker off of your backing, if it actually had cut correctly. But since it didn't, it's like nearly impossible again. But in general, did this work? Yes. Do I think that it's worth the hassle? Absolutely not. Do it the other way. It's easier. You're going to get a better cut. You're going to get a better outline. Like, I don't feel like this, I would have used custom. This is a little too big. But I do think, like, if you're getting used to making stickers, is it a helpful tool? Sure. But is it something that I would recommend people use? Absolutely not. I would highly recommend just doing them yourself. Now, if you guys have any questions about this, let me know in the comments down below. I can definitely do like a more in-depth video where we do a few different stickers. We try it with some Cricut product. Like I said, I would have to buy the Cricut product, but I'd be willing to try it for you guys just to see if we even like the way it works and if it works with Cricut products or not. I do wish they would offer you to choose your own cut setting, but they don't, which is kind of a pain. And remember, you do have to be a Cricut Access member. I hope you all have a wonderful day, and as always, happy crafting!